Welcome, Don.
Good afternoon.
Good to see you again.
You as well.
Nice to see you look like you're doing better here as of recently.
Recently, I do feel a lot better right now. I've been doing my normal meditation. I just can't seem to get along with my roommates, but we're making it work.
I know you've talked about your roommates and stuff. Kind of related to, you know, sometimes your triggers or cravings for methamphetamine. However, still remaining sober, which is outstanding. How are you doing with, tell me about some of the interactions with roommates.
There's a couple of my roommates that just show up that, and they look obviously high.
Yeah.
And I just...
Sometimes it's part of a system.
Sometimes it just makes it gets me overwhelmed and I get anxious and I don't know what to do.
Yeah.
Get a little angry.
Right. I know we've worked a lot on cognitive behavioral therapy with some of your cognition as far as you remember. We kind of go over it again. You know, your beliefs go into what your thoughts are. That's how you look at your emotions and then the behavior. Are you trying to practice some of that?
I try to, but sometimes it just gets the better of me and I don't know what to do.
Right, right. Back to the roommates. Have you been able to let your house manager know?
I've told him a few times, but he just doesn't seem to care.
How are you able to stay sober? Are you working with your sponsor still and going to meetings?
I call my sponsor probably 20 times a day and I'm sure he doesn't. I got to do something to make
it. Well, it's good that you're asking for help before you relapse.
I'm trying to do it the best way I can. I've been to 20 treatment centers, and I want to be done with this. I'm already old as dirt, and I want to just be done with it.
Well, you're doing a great job, and you shouldn't overlook that. You've got 4 or 5 months sober now. You know, I know sometimes with roommates in a sober living in, you know, a mental health facility, outpatient can be challenging. I know sometimes the house manager can be on your side, maybe not be on your side.
It just seems like he's too busy to deal with me, and I don't know why that is. Maybe
so
everybody else is so young, and I just feel out of place.
Yeah, right.
Maybe it's just part of my mental health that's causing this.
Sure, and I know for, you know, you've come a long way with anxiety, you know, taking medications. You've been compliant there this week, assuming?
The Zoloft seems to be helping sometimes.
Okay.
The boost bar in the morning doesn't seem like it's enough, but it does something for me.
Right, right. So it brings it down a little bit, but not completely comfortable all the time.
I haven't felt comfortable in my own skin in a long time.
Yeah. I know this is the first time you've gotten sober.
Really sober, yes.
Really sober, right. Going through treatment, now living outpatient. How's the job search been going lately?
It went all right. I put out like about 5 applications this week. I don't know if I'm a good fit for it or not.
We're just looking for a get well job. It doesn't have to be, you know, the job that, you know, is going to be a career yet. But just try and doing some work. I know you mentioned that you're also going to do some volunteering at the previous detox facility. How's that going?
I went and I did a couple of days, and then somebody came in like super loaded, and it freaked me out.
So kind of gave you some triggers and cravings, right?
I had to go outside and do some breathing.
Do some deep breathing, right?
To get myself back into right frame of mind, but I couldn't.
I still think that you are effectively using the CBT and the deep breathing exercise as well. I know that your own personal evaluation might be that you're still struggling, but I think from when we started months ago about what your negative thought patterns, what you believed, I think you've begun to change those, maybe without knowing that you're doing that, because again, as you come into session each week, it seems to be more positive for you, and you're still sober.
I'm hanging on, you know. That's all I can do. I'm doing the best I can do with what I got.
How the guys who are you're not in conflict with, and I know I've met and worked with a lot of them, how do they support you in recovery? How are you guys doing with that?
They let me just vent to them a little bit, and that seems to help get through some of the anxiety of it. I get really pissed off, and so I go for a walk. Frank picks me up and takes me, and we go to the meeting, and I get to share a little bit, and that's a good way for me to get it out.
Excellent. I know you continue to repeat that pattern of, you know, support to use, stopping and thinking really about, okay, what I believe, is how I'm going to think, and the emotions that go with that, and then the behavior, and if it's a positive belief, a positive thought, and the emotion becomes more regulated for you. And I know when you practice it, I've seen your behavior improve. So I want to compliment you on that today.
I appreciate that. Thank you. It's definitely foreign for me to even think about doing that.
It's early. Yeah, I agree. It's early.
But for me to even be where I'm at right now, my hat's off to you for helping me get through this.
Well, I have to credit you because you've come to these sessions each week. Sometimes it's been in crisis. You and I have found a solution. We've kind of broken down, what it exactly is. Is it, craving and triggers for drugs? Is it more anxiety driven? And I think
it's anxiety driven, really, more than anything. But I mean, it's kind of a toss up on what the actual trigger is. I mean, just the air blowing sometimes.
Yeah, good day, bad day, could be anything, right? And you kind of began to evaluate yourself and kind of learn what your, where you can go and what your limits are, and trying to stay safe, because again, right now, early like this, I think it's important to understand that your sobriety, we've kind of established your sobriety being number one.
Absolutely.
With the CBT, we've established that we can reduce things, bring the anxiety a little bit down. And I know that makes you feel better.
It does help. It does make me feel more comfortable.
How do you feel about your overall progress right now?
Right now, I try not to overprocess anything because once I start overthinking it, it sometimes triggers my anxiety. I'm tired of feeling like that. I mean, it's super hard for me to get over.
It's, again, in the early stages, like this is a struggle. But I remember a couple months ago, and, could barely even sit there.
5 months ago, I wouldn't even be able to do anything.
Yeah, and I think, again, you really should credit yourself, pat yourself on the back, and hopefully that gives you some hope. You've been really motivated lately. Your motivation seems like it's increasing.
I definitely want something new. Spent the last 20 years of my life using meth. Is the only thing that really gives me any kind of release or comfort. So maybe
you mentioned those meds are working a little bit though. They're a little bit more slow acting. They won't be instant.
Well, I'm looking for that instantaneous release, and it just doesn't happen, I guess.
What are your plans for the weekend? As far as maintaining your sobriety, what does that look like?
Our meeting hall has a barbecue going on this week.
Nice.
I think I'm going to head down there and see what I can do. Try to get involved in some sober fun.
Awesome. Well, you've been listening to the suggestions. That's great.
Absolutely.
Awesome.
I'm an open book at this point. I just want to be better.
Have you read anything more about the smart recovery lately? I know that's been a challenge. You still kind of looking into that?
I'm still looking into it. It's confusing to me.
Yeah, it's not the easiest to grab onto. I know that you're, at the beginning where we weren't working any module and we decided to do some meetings, we decided to maybe try and find a sponsor, and we wanted to add the smart recovery know, doing the online means, just to remind you, the smartrecovery.org.
It just doesn't seem as personal to me, doing it online.
Yeah, it's not. I think it would help, though, with, like, the belief systems. It kind of goes along with the CBT. I know you're not real open to it yet, but you are kind of start looking at it a little bit.
I guess I could give it a shot, but I don't know, man. It just seems odd. I don't even like the 12 steps, but it seems to be helping me.
It's a lot of overwhelming information, I know.
It just seems too personal for me to be out there like that.
Yeah, understood. How do you feel about me giving you some more homework with, the smart recovery and the CBT again? Would you like me to give you some handouts?
I think I would like the some
more. Maybe just try it.
If you can give me the ABC handout again, that would be
awesome. Yeah, right. Yeah, I can give that to you, absolutely, and we can probably next session go through that together.
That would probably help.
Excellent. I wanted to do our deep breathing next, okay. Don, if that's okay.
Absolutely.
We'll do it like we normally do together. So we'll sit on the, just to kind of review, we'll sit on the edge of the seat.
Yes, sir.
We've got our two legs down here, and we got the 90 degree angle between our knee and our leg, and we've got both our hands on our knees here. And what we'll do is we'll do three steps. We'll do taking in 8 seconds.
Okay.
We'll hold for 8 seconds, and then we're going to let out for 8 seconds.
Okay.
And we'll do that three repetitions,
perfect,
just like we have before. And I know it'll help both of us. And,
fresh air.
Really try. Absolutely. Get those anxiety levels down. Absolutely. Okay, so we'll go ahead and start. One.
You feel a lot calmer, that's for sure.
Me too. I think that has a lot of merit. It really helps bring all physiological symptoms down a little bit. It kind of gets our mind not from racing, kind of takes the worries away a little bit.
How do I do that without looking like a fool?
Well, I know. That's a great question, Don. I know we've talked about that before. It's probably not something you want to do like in the backyard or inside the house or anything like that. And I think if you find a good place, like maybe in your room when your roommate's not there, or people aren't around, but if you want to practice that continually, throughout the week, maybe a couple times a day, I think it'll really help with anxiety. Maybe slowed down and not thinking too much about math.
I tried to do it during my morning meditation too, so.
Terrific. Well, I wanted to go into conclusion now. Did a great job today. I'm real proud of you and your progress.
I appreciate that. I need all the help I can get.
I'm always here to support you.
Yes,
you have my phone number, have my text message. I will probably go ahead and shut off the video here in a second.
Okay.
But I'm going to give you the handouts on CBT. On Smart Recovery, give you that website. I'd like you to look into it. Try and read the ABCs that we talked about again. And again, if something comes up, give me a call. Hit your meetings. And most importantly, stay sober. And I guess we'll wrap it up there for today.
All right, I appreciate it. Thank you so
much. Thanks, Don. Appreciate it.
Thank you, John.
All right.